Alright, this is my second video on how to find the least common multiple. In this method, I'm going to show you how to find the least common multiple of a list of numbers by building it up. And what I mean is I'm going to build it up from prime numbers. So here's how we begin. The first number in the list is 12, and I'm going to write the prime factorization of that. So underneath each of these, just as a reminder, the prime factorization of 12 is 2 times 2 times 3. For 45, it is 3 times 3 times 5, and for 35, it's 5 times 7. So we've already gone over how to find the prime factorization. So what we do is we think of the prime factorization of the numbers, and notice I'm not using exponents in this method. So I'm now going to write the least common multiple of these numbers by building it up. Well, to have the factors of 12 in it, I need to have all the factors in 12, all the prime numbers. So I need a 2, 2, and a 3. So I'm going to just start off with 2, 2, and 3. And now, of course, I have a multiple of 12. I also need a multiple of 45. So I've got to make sure I have two factors of 3 and a 5. So what do I need to multiply in here? I already have 1, 3. I need another 3 and a 5. I have just built up the least common multiple to include a multiple of 12 and 45. If I remove any of these five factors, it's either not going to be a multiple of 12 or a multiple of 45. Now, I also need to have the factors of 35 in the least common multiple. All right, I already have my 5, so all I need to do is get a 7 in there. And there we go. That's the least common multiple of 12, 45, and 35. And you could see how I built it up. So then we just multiply all those together. And I think that is 1260. All right, let's do another one. Okay, find the least common denominator 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, when you first look at that, you think, oh my gosh, that's just so many numbers. How am I ever going to be able to figure that out? But, you know, if you do this building up method, it's not really so bad. And I've given you numbers that you should be able to prime factor in your head. It's going to be a pretty big number because we're trying to find a number that all those numbers go into without a remainder. So starting off with 4, I need a 2 times a 2. Okay, I'm just going to factor in my head this time. Now for 5, the prime factorization of 5 is 5. I make sure I get a 5 in there. There it is. 6, what do you need for 6? You need a 2 times 3. I have 1, 2 already in there, so I'm going to build it up by putting in a 3. 7 is prime, so I need to just put that in there. There isn't a 7 yet. How about 8? That's 2 times 2 times 2. All right, so I need 3 factors of 2. I need to get a 2 in there. All right, almost done. 9. 9 is 3 times 3. I've got 1 factor of 3, so I need 1 more factor of 3. And what about 10? 10, if you factor it, is 2 times 5. It's already in there. So this is the prime factorization of the least common multiple, and then you can get out a calculator and multiply. All right, so the least common multiple is 2,520. Wow, that would have taken a long time if we just started listing all the factors of all those numbers. Don't even go there. But look at how fast and easy it was by just building it up. Let's try another one. Okay, put the video on pause and try getting the least common multiple of these five numbers using the building up method. Okay, here we go. 6 is 2 times 3. So we start off with that. Now we're going to go on to 9. 9 is 3 times 3. So I need another factor of 3. So now I've got the least common multiple of 6 and 9. If you multiply it out, you would get 18, right? That's the least common multiple of 6 and 9. And I want the least common multiple of 10 also to be in there. I want the factors of 10 also to be in there. So I need 2 times 5. All right, got to put in a 5. For 15, I need a 3 times 5. Hey, check it out, I already got it. And for 18, well, 18 is 2 times 9, right? So I need a 2 times a 3 times a 3. Check it out, I've already got it. So this is it. I didn't have to throw in any more factors for 15 or 18. So we simply multiply those together. and we get 90, and that's the least common multiple of 6, 9, 10, 15, and 18. Isn't this fun and easy and cool? All right. Hey, by the way, this is harder than anything they ever give you in a book. If you could do these, you've really got it. All right, so here we go. Find the least common multiple of 14, 15, 20, 25, and 28. See if you could do this on your own by putting it on pause first. Okay, let's do it. 14, oh, that's 2 times 7. 15, that's 3 times 5. So you don't have either of those yet, so we have 3 times 5. 20. All right, now you have to remember the factors of 20 are 2 times 2 times 5. I have one factor of 2. So I need another factor of 2. That's your 4 times 5. 5's already there. 25 is 5 times 5. All right, so I have one 5. I need another 5. And 28, that's 14 times 2, right? So it's 2 times 7 times 2. And notice I already have a 2, a 7, and a 2 in there. So we are done. All we need to do is get out a calculator and multiply those factors together. All right, you should get 2100. By the way, you could maybe do that in your head without a calculator, because check this out. See that 2 times 5? That's 10. And here's another 2 times 5. That's 10. And so you've got 21 times 10 times 10, which is 2100. So sometimes it's easier not to get out a calculator. Let's try one more. Okay, here we go. Bigger numbers this time, but with this method, no problem. All right, let's start off with 21. That's going to be 3 times 7. All right, 35, I need 5 times 7. I've already got the 7, so I need to get a factor of 5. 49, that's 7 times 7. So I have one factor of 7, get another 7 in there. Now for 60, I'm going to write the prime factorization using a factor treat, because you might not be able to do that in your head. So remember that 6 times 10, 2 times 3, 2 times 5. So my factors are 2, I've got 2 factors of 2. So you know what, I need to get 2 factors of 2 in there. So I need a 2 times a 2, and I need a 3, which I already have, and I need 1 5, which I already have. So that's the least common multiple, and then we simply multiply all those numbers together. So the least common multiple of those four numbers is 2940. Okay, so that's the method. If you have a list of numbers, this is especially easy if you have a whole bunch of numbers. Just use the prime factorization and build it on up. Now, on the next video I'm going to show you an easy way to get the least common multiple when you just have two numbers. You don't need to use any particular method. All you need to do is know how to get the least common multiple using at least one method. It's nice to have an option, though. You might like one method over the other one. So practice and have fun with this.